Hello, I'm Duke of the Bump. Welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux. We just made it to level 2. We just saved our game. We are breaking camp, and we are seeing what this level has in store for us. See, I haven't fought any monsters bigger than the bugbear yet, correct? Every boss has, every level has an enemy that's slightly tougher than the rest of the enemies on that level. And that's kind of considered the boss of that level, sort of. Now on this level, theoretically, we should be running into a bunch more bugbears. I think that's a hobgoblin, actually. Yep, that was a hobgoblin. Nothing special about hobgoblins either, I don't think. They're just a slightly tougher version of goblins. Alright, so now I have an obsidian ring and an agate ring. Why didn't the dot show up on my map? That was weird. Ooh, more rations. I'll go ahead and eat those now, since I was getting kind of low on food. Soundtrack is more sword and sorcery. That's sorcery with a W. SWORCY. It's a cool little independent adventure game. I recommend checking it out. I played a little bit. I enjoyed it. For whatever reason, I didn't go back to it. I probably will one of these days, whether on camera or off, on quote unquote camera. All right, let's re-up my aid spell. Give myself some more temporary hit points. It's usually pretty easy to figure out how to open the doors. Either there's a button or a keyhole, or there's a keyhole on the other side. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and use this wand as soon as I see an enemy. I am pretty sure there's no reason not to use a wand. I don't think there's such thing as a cursed wand. See, that was just a weird looking switch. Interesting. Pretty sure I heard the sound of some sort of undead nightmare shambling around. Sounds like it's behind this door, but I don't have that kind of key. Well, I will have to come back here. Oops, I meant to use my wand. Oh well. Oh god! Alright, that is a ghoul. Oh, this wand does nothing. Uh-oh. I forget if I have any more flame blade spells or not. Now, if your spell menu is open when you hit the camp button, then you can come in here and kind of make sure you're on the right page. But you can't actually cast spells from within this menu. So I'll break camp and cast Flame Blade. Now I could use Turn Undead, but all that would do is make it run away from. Oh crap! I'm held. See, when you're held or paralyzed, all that means is you can't attack. You can still run away, which makes it pretty. A pretty minor threat. Alright. I think that was a ghoul. Yes, that was indeed a ghoul. Ghouls are kind of a lesser undead creature. They don't have any... Well, I mean, they can hold you. Not literally hold you. They don't, like, give you a hug. Although they might, if you were cuddly enough. But no, in D&D, held just means you're, like... I mean, it's supposed to mean you're held in place, but... That would be a little too cruel for this game. Oh, I see where I haven't been yet. Okay. I mean, if you had to just sit there and let the enemies pound you, then that would be pretty unfair. Because unlike in NetHack or Rogue, I go with NetHack because that's the roguelike I'm the most familiar with. You can only There can only be one enemy standing next to you in one spot at a time. So, like, say I was standing here. There could be one enemy standing here, one enemy standing here, one enemy standing here. So that's three. But in this game, multiple enemies can be on the same square. I don't know. There's, a limit. I think it's at least two, probably three or four. So, you know, if I got paralyzed here, I could potentially be swarmed by, a dozen enemies, which would be impossible to survive. Aw, oh, man. For crying out loud. You also can't use magic while you're held, which is annoying. Alright, I'll try to avoid getting hit by these guys again. I mean, ideally, you try to avoid getting hit by everything, but things don't always go ideally. Did I find that plume on this level, or was that the previous level? Pretty sure it was this level, because I went through every door on level 1. I don't know, I don't remember. It's important to make a mental note whenever, whenever you pass by something that you need to remember. I mean, really, I should have like a notepad and a pencil sitting next to me to write down stuff like that. Like for example, over here, I need like, I forget what kind of key goes in that lock. It's like a crystal key or something like that. And there are no more doors other than that one that I don't have a key for. So I guess it's time to start bumping into walls. I definitely don't have that. It wasn't this kind of key. It wasn't a copper lock. It was blue and it looked like a crystal. And there are no other locked doors, correct? Yeah, okay. Alright. Face, don't fail me now. Oh, there we go. And that's not the key I need either. Great. I mean, I'm assuming I'm bumping into these walls with my face, which is why it says, oh, every single time. I mean, it's kind of weird that, like, a seasoned adventurer would look for secret passages that way. Like, the only way he can think to test out these walls is to mash his face against them. You know, I mean, that's kind of a scrub move. You know, that's amateur town. Oh, come on. He has his back to me. How do I miss him? I mean, he's moving at like a quarter of a mile an hour. Oh, come on. Man, my Thaco leaves a lot to be desired. Oh, this isn't fantasy music. Oh, that's the key I need, the crystal key. Okay, great. Alright, let me equip this amulet and see if it's a wand or amulet of magic missiles or lightning bolts or something. There are amulets that do something when you put them around your neck, but they seem to be less common. Yeah, see, that's an amulet of magic missiles. Nice. I mean, it seems kind of weird and counterintuitive that most amulets are used by placing them in your hand and, like... Well, I guess that's kind of the same as the holy symbol. Like, you use it by holding it up. I guess the amulets kind of work the same way. Of course, when I play D&D, we usually fudge it and say that clerics can just have their holy symbol around their neck and use them that way, so they don't have to, like, occupy one of their hands with their holy symbol. So they can hold, like, a mace and a shield or whatever. Oh, crap. I'm about to get surrounded. That's not good. Okay, good. Alright, let's go ahead and cure light. We don't need to cure Sirius yet. Tiger Eye, that's another key. Oh, our flame blade is gone. Let's go ahead and rest up. So yeah, as long as you can get into a spot where you can rest, you're in pretty good shape. Alright. Bless. Aid. And blade. It's the ABBs of being a cleric. ABB. Always. Blade. Bees. I should probably just go ahead and test these potions by using them. Because, I mean, they're not doing me any good sitting in my inventory. And eventually, I'm going to have to start making room. I'm hoping that I find a magic mirror, which allows you to identify items. Like, I mean, it has a limited number of charges, but you can identify, like, half a dozen items with a magic mirror. In my practice playthrough, I found two of them before, like, level 4. But I haven't found any yet in this playthrough. I'm sure I will, eventually. Oh, come on. I was nowhere near that damn ghoul. Okay. Fine, you held me. You feel like a big man? Figure I should demonstrate the properties of this. I put a silver coin in and I'm healed all the way up. Not strictly necessary as a cleric, but it's nice that it's there. I'll never make it through here. You know, it looks like I could probably just squeeze under this guy's arm. I mean, that's not like a tight squeeze or anything. I mean, I'm sure I can make it. Especially if I was a halfling. If I was a halfling, I could slip through there no problem. But it would probably still say there's no way through. Alright, I have a plethora of different ways I can go over here. Let's see, copper key. I think I have one of those. Hobnobbing with the hobgoblins. Whoa. I just realized the statue, it's facing the same way no matter which side you're standing. Well, which side of the stat- oh. Hey, I was trying to talk about the statue. That's very rude of you to just come up and start messing up my narration like that. It's like this guy never heard of a Let's Play. Jeez. Or maybe he has heard of them and he just doesn't like them. I don't want to hear you talk, just play the game. That was my impression of a ghoul who does not like LPs. Let's see, fire key. Fire key. I have one of them. Haha, stab that guy in the back. Now, if you're standing next to them when they start their attack animation, then it doesn't matter how quickly you back away. The hit's going to either hit or miss you. I mean, it's not... There's no way to outrun that kind of... Once the animation starts, there's no way to outrun it. Like that. The animation... It was already in effect. Nothing I could do. Alright, that should be good for now. I see you sneaking up there. You jerk. Iron rations. Iron rations, they just give you more food than normal rations. So, I should save those, I guess, for last. I'll probably... Whoa! It's like a dart trap. That was weird. I'll probably get the create food and water spell before I run out of food. So, it's not going to be a big deal, most likely. Oh, come on. I'd back away, but I don't want to walk into those darts. You too? Oh, great. I'm held. Alright, I better get out of there. Don't want to get trapped by a ghoul. Ow, jeez. Wait. Oh, I thought there was like a crossfire of darts. Never mind. Man, that trap is just going. It's not like triggered by standing in front of it or anything. It just... it just goes. Ooh. So wait, what was the deal with that other wand that I found? Did it not do anything? Oh, I've used... Oh. Huh. I bet it... I don't know what it did. It didn't look like it had any effect. Oh well, there's no point in keeping it if there are no charges. Alright, so I have an amulet to test, and I have another wand to test. So let's go find some ghoulies. That one didn't do anything either. I clicked on it, and nothing happened. On the other one, I just clicked it a bunch of times, and now it says it's out of charges. That was really weird. Okay, this is not good. I was going to say, this is the kind of amulet that you have to actually put around your neck. So, I'll hold on to that, cure myself, slash this guy. Okay, I'm in good shape. I should probably go on ahead and rest, actually. Yeah, let's go on ahead and do that. I want to hold on to this amulet until I get something that can remove curses, because if it's the kind that you actually wear, there's a chance it can be cursed. I believe, I don't know, there might not be cursed amulets. I'm not 100% sure about all of the curse mechanics of this game. Alright. Bless Blade Aid. BBA. Alright, I have a big old room here to explore. Big old empty room. That's not worth exploring. Alright, let's look at my map. Where do I need to go? Alright, let's pop down this hallway and then this one before I start exploring the lower half of the map. Try not to get hit by... I think those are magic missiles, actually, not darts. So I'm actually playing another... like dungeon crawler type game at the moment. On the 3DS, I'm playing the most recent Etrian Odyssey game. That's the RPG series where it's all about mapping out the dungeons. Like there's an auto map option, but you can like turn that off and actually draw the map like completely. You can draw the walls, draw the floors, everything about it. I have the auto mapping turned on, so the only thing I have to draw are like landmarks and stuff. Something seems to be missing here. I don't think it's the tiger eye, is it? Oh, do I need to just put a weight there? A rock? No. I don't know, I guess I haven't found the key that goes in this. I was going to say scale, but there's only one of them, so. I think that's called a censer, like what you put incense in. Alright, well, I guess I'll have to come back here, even though it looks like there's probably nothing there. That's that wand I dropped, I think. But yeah, Etrian Odyssey, it's a lot of fun. I'll probably pick up the full game. Oh, alright. The darts. It's more of a turn-based JRPG style game, though. I mean, you walk around in first person like in Dungeon Hack, but the actual combat is done in like a turn-based JRPG kind of setting. Well, this cloak, it might be like a cloak of invisibility or something, so I'll hang on to it. To get rid of curses, there's a dispel curse spell that clerics get. Yet another reason to play clerics. You have spells that can take care of curses and poison. Oh god. It's a shadow. That must be the quote unquote boss of this level. Alright, let's use some magic missiles on this guy. Bam! Bam! Yeah, that looks very similar to that trap, so I think it was a magic missile trap. Alright. One shadow. And we've still only found the one bugbear, and that's kind of weird. I was expecting there to be more. Maybe next level. I thought I had two blue potions, but I guess I was thinking of the periwinkle potion. If I had two of them, I'd go ahead and drink one and see what it does. Potion or scroll of water breathing, which I won't need because I turned water levels off. Oh, there's the exit too. Nice. Alright, well, let's take care of this area and this area. And if I find whatever goes in that lock, I'll check out that area as well. Even though it looks like it's just going to be a dead end, because there's just going to be one square there. Protection from cold, I'll hang on to that, in case I fight any cold-based enemies. Get my, my holy symbol back. Uh-oh. Okay, what? Wait, no, that's not good either. Trying not to get myself boxed in. Crap. Man, I can't hit anything today. Uh-oh. This might not be good. Well, I do have the amulet of imminent return, so if push comes to shove, I can get out of here. There is a limited number of charges, I believe, though, so I have to be careful, because I don't want to get stuck and think, oh, I'll use my amulet to get out of here, and then I do that, and it's out of charges, and I just die. If I do die during any of these videos, by the way, I'm just going to end the video there, and then, like, if I died... Well, that was a pit. I didn't think pits showed up that early in the game. Can I use my grappling hook here? Or is that only... Okay. Okay, good. It wasn't even hidden or anything, I don't think. It was just... I was like... See, my first thought was, whoa, another set of stairs? But, nope. Alright, well, see, that's where the grappling hook comes in handy, because I was not ready to be down there yet. However, I did go up level, which is nice. I am now level 5, meaning I have... still have 5 level 1 spells, but I have an extra level 2 spell. So, I will get, in my last LP, I was using Spiritual Hammer a lot, but I don't know if that's the way I want to go. I don't know. I haven't really decided yet. I think for now, I'm just going to take another aid. Oh, I do have level 3 spells now. Great. See, this is where you get all the necessary spells. You get Create Food and Water. You get Negative Plane Protection, which protects you from losing levels when you get hit by certain enemies that make you lose levels. We'll encounter those later. You get Remove Paralysis. You get Remove Curse. You don't get Remove Poison until a later level, though. But I do have Slow Poison. So if I do get poisoned, then... Well, if I do get poisoned, then I'll want one of these, like, ready. Actually, I think that's what I'll do. I'll take a Slow Poison, just in case. And then for level 3... Well, I still have plenty of food, so I don't need to create food and water just yet. So I'm going to get prayer, which is basically a better version of aid. And, well, for now, actually, let's get 2 remove curses and check all of these items. Let's rest up. I'm glad I found that grappling hook. I mean, I'm sure I'm ready for the next level, but it sucks to just be dropped into the middle of it like that. Oh wait, you know what I should do? I should get a detect magic, so I don't have to waste time checking non-magical things. Oh wait, I have one. Okay, great. Alright, so, cast. I did not mean to click that, I meant to click 2. And cast Flame Blade, just in case I get attacked while I'm doing this. Alright, let's check these boots. Well, let's cast Detect Magic first. Alright, boots aren't magic. We can, well, check our armor class 5 and 5, so we can just drop the boots. Don't need to worry about them. Bracers. Armor class is 5. Doesn't seem to affect any of my stats. Well, they are magical, so they do something. Can't tell what, though. Maybe it's just an attack boost, which isn't showing up here because it doesn't show you any sort of attack stat. Okay, well, let's check these bracers. Same thing, magical, but I don't know what they do. By the way, for non-D&D nerds, a lower armor class is better. I should have explained that. I'm looking for this number to become lower. Alright, well, I guess it's a crapshoot as to which set of bracers I want to use then. Okay, let's check these rings. If they're cursed, I have removed curse now, so I don't have to worry about it. The obsidian ring. I cannot tell what it does. I mean, there are plenty of rings that don't affect your stats at all. There's a ring that makes it so you don't need food. There's a ring that slowly regenerates you. I don't actually know what all the rings are. Check the shield, actually. That's an interesting... Alright, so that lowers my armor class by 2, which is pretty good. I'll probably start carrying this around instead of the holy symbol, and just bring the holy symbol out when I need it. Okay, robes. Or cloak. Okay, that lowers my armor class, or raises my armor class considerably, which is bad. Doesn't make me invisible. Doesn't raise my dexterity. So yeah, I'm probably not going to use this cloak. I'll hold on to it, though, in case I can identify it later. Ring. Oh, wait. I think that, this ring raises my strength. Interesting. So it's a ring of strength plus 1. Nice. This one, still can't tell. Oh, well. I'll keep it on. It's not cursed, so why not? This amulet, this is just a necklace. Doesn't do anything because it's not glowing blue. Alright, I think that's it. I can check the potions, but I still want to have some way to cure poison or something. Let's alright, I put my amulet of imminent return here, have my holy symbol there, so it's, you know, at the ready. Alright, I think I'm ready to get going. Alright, what else do I need to do in this level? I need to finish exploring this area and explore down here. Okay. Sorry for the little pause. I needed to, I had a lot of items that I needed to check now that I have the ability to remove cursed items. There's also magical dust that if you use it, it gets rid of any curses on you, but I haven't found any of that yet. So yeah. I mean, that's one of the best reasons to play a cleric. I feel like spiders are crawling all over my body. What is that? Did something happen to me? Or is that just flavor text? I don't know. I don't think I've ever seen that before. Oh man, I'm gonna have to go all the way around to get over to the right. Oh well, shouldn't take me that long. But yeah, I mean, water breathing, yeah, don't need that. I mean, just imagine if I was, the wand doesn't have any charges. Just imagine if I was a fighter, and I had all these items, but I had no way of knowing if they were cursed or not. Because once you get a cursed item, that's it, you can't remove it. Unless you can remove the curse somehow. And if I was a fighter, or a mage, or whatever, the only way I could do that is to get lucky enough to find the magic dust, which, you know, good luck. It might never show up. You might go a whole dungeon without ever finding the magic dust, in which case you're just boned. You have to use the cursed items forever. So, wait. Okay. Oh, shit. Oh, wow. I let those magic missiles walk right into me. I was trying to get my bearings here. Okay, here we go. And open. And there's nothing over here. Great. I still don't know where the whatever item I need to open that other door is. I tried the tiger eye, right? No, I know what kind of lock this goes in. It's like an actual literal tiger, and you have to put an eye in there. So I don't know what kind of key goes in the one half of the scale. Flame Blade expired. Let's get my holy symbol ready. Oh, you can't put the shield in the quick item slot. Normally, you would use these slots for ammo. If you're using like a sling, you would put rocks here and sling the rocks at enemies. But since I don't have ranged weapons and I'm not planning on using them, I just use these to store items I want to be able to access quickly, like my holy symbol. All right, actually, I need to cast aid again. And I haven't cast prayer yet, which I should. Oh wait, I didn't get prayer. I got two remove curses. Okay, so I'll just cast bless. Wait, maybe your health bar only turns blue if you have above the maximum allowed hit points. That makes sense. Oh my god, it's a menagerie in there. It's a monster zoo. We bought a zoo and it's full of monsters. Why did we buy this monster zoo? That's the worst purchase decision I ever made. I mean, I guess these early level monsters, the whole point of them is they're scary in numbers. So, no need to panic. I have the situation totally under control. Alright, these are the boots that are non-magical, so I can just set those there. Oh, there's a tiger eye. Great. And it's another monster zoo. Monster zoo is a term from NetHack, just to describe a room full of monsters like that. Oh my god, there's so many of them. I didn't see any rooms that full of monsters during my my practice game. Alright, once I am no longer held, I'll need to heal up. Do-do-do-do-do. Maybe I should just turn that undead. Did it work? No, I guess I have to be right next to him. Damn. Oh, Lord. Hey, how's it going? Not much, just hanging out with you. The ghoul is like the guy who sits down next to you at the bus stop. And you can't get away from him. You just want someone to talk to. Alright, let's see what the journal page does. Oh god. I was reading, you jerk. And thus I lose several of my spells when the white struck and took from me a portion of my life energy. That's a hint. Whites are an enemy that drains levels from you. Which is one of the worst things that can happen to you in this game. Because you don't level up super fast in this game. I mean, I've gone up one level, but the higher level you are, obviously the longer it takes. And if you're like level 9 and you get knocked down to level, like, I mean, it's not like a temporary effect, it's permanent. And it's cumulative, so if you get struck by a white several times in a row, and the level drain happens several times in a row, you are just out of luck. Which is one of the numerous reasons you should be a cleric, so you can cast negative plane protection. Protect yourself. Before, you don't need to wreck yourself because the whites will do it for you. Okay, I wanted to check that wall. It looked a little suspicious, but it was a real wall. Okay, well, I think I'm mostly done here. Okay, let's check out this room. Once again, I'm looking at my mini-map instead of the playing field, so I apologize if I missed anything. I have seen a few of those alcoves, but they've been empty, so I don't think I've missed anything. I bet that Agit... Agate? Agate? I have no idea, but I bet that's what I need to open that last door. That might be a magical throwing hammer. Once I'm clear, I'll get my spells back and do another detect magic. Now that I don't have any items that I need to ID, let's get rid of remove curse and get prayer. Actually, I'll take one of each, just in case. Let's see. Still doing pretty good on food, but once I'm not, I'll just get create food and water and I'll be fine. Cast an aid. Cast a prayer. Now that I have prayer, I don't need bless, I don't think, because I'm pretty sure they don't stack. I think the prayer supersedes the bless, if it's anything like tabletop D&D. Detect magic. Okay, it is a magical throwing hammer. Oh wait, that's right, I can't use it because my flame sword is unremovable. Alright, well, let's head to that last door and see if there's anything in that one square on the map. It's probably not. I do feel like I'm kicking a lot more ass than I was in the last episode, which is nice. It's a good feeling, leveling up, becoming more powerful, being able to take care of foes that gave you problems before without breaking a sweat. Am I going the right way? No, I'm going the exact wrong way, but I'm almost there. Alright, Adjet, show me what's in here. It's a ghoul. And that's it. This looks to have once held holy water. It has long gone dry, however. It has long gone dry. It has long since gone dry. Well, I'm an adventurer, not a grammar. Alright, so the stairs down are here, I'm here, so... Okay. There's no setting checkpoints in this game. No... I mean, there is a compass, but it only points in the directions that a compass points. It doesn't point you to your objective. You know, there's no Dead Space-style breadcrumbs. Hold down a button and it shows you exactly where you need to go. This is 1993 video games. There's no green arrow on the map pointing in the exact right direction. This is hardcore. Alright. That is everything once again. I bet there's a secret door here or here somewhere that would fill this in. I'm not going to go back and check, though. It's not worth it. Alright, well, this has been Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux Level 2. This has been awesome. I'm having a lot of fun. Hope you guys are having fun watching. And tune in tomorrow for Level 3. Let's go ahead and save my game. Level 3. Enter. Alright. So, see you tomorrow.